Team. Indian Computer Response Team is the national nodal agency for responding to cybersecurity incidents in the country. This webcast is regarding a critical alert we have issued on Saturday regarding a ransomware that is a kind of malware that is predicted to be spreading widely across the globe. Ransomware is a malware that encrypts contents of infected systems and demands payment in bitcoins. So far, this impact of this ransomware has been reported is some of the hospitals in England have been hit. Some of the hospitals in England have been hit, and Russia, Spain, Frankfurt, USA and academic institution China have been affected by this ransomware. Very few reports are reported from our country as well. So how it is spreading? This particular malware or ransomware spreads to the Windows systems by exploiting a vulnerability in the Windows systems, which is in the server message block component, which is normally used to do the network sharing and LAN on the network. And there are two key components in this particular malware. There is a WOM part, which used to propagate across the network, and the ransomware package. This exploit is named as Eternal Blue by the various IDS and IPS solutions. And the initial ransom that has been reported is being asked as $300 US, and later on it increases to $600 US in Bitcoin. So what, as a user or as an organization, where you see if your system is infected? This screenshot will be shown on the computer's screen, and this message being displayed by the malware or ransomware, and it advises how to recover your files. So this displays this wallpaper as well, and it says that if you see this text but don't see the WANA decryptor window, then your antivirus is removed the decrypt software or you deleted it from your computer. And if you need your files from files, you have to run the decrypt software. This message is to scare the user that his data is encrypted and lost. And by scaring the users, the attackers want to collect money from the user. And there is also a file named pleaseReadMe.txt, which is dropped on the infected system, and it has certain questions: what is wrong with my files, and what should I do, and drop password file and all those things. So you are cautioned to not to run these files again further when you see the infected system. And this malware also drops user manuals in different languages: Bulgarian, Chinese, Croatian, English. So our systems in India are using English supported versions, so you will see most probably the English version of the files. And the ransomware targets the following extensions, encrypts the files with the following extensions. So your files, once you are infected, it will be targeted, and these targeted files will be encrypted with the extension .wcry. So if you see here, the Word documents and PDF files, presentations, PDFs, RAR files, it's all are targeted by this malware. And the malware also targets commonly used Office extensions, less common and national specific Office formats such as .odt, archives and media files, emails, .eml, .msg, .pst files, database files, .sql, .dbf, .myd files, developer source code project files, where many developers may be using these extensions and storing their files. And encryption keys and certificates are also encrypted with this particular ransomware, and graphic designers files and virtual machine files. And for technically sound users, this is the files that are dropped in program data, and the file name of the malware is taskschedule.exe, and in the C Windows folder, the file name ms.svc.exe and task.sh.exe are dropped. And the ransomware is granting full access by using following commands. And there is a batch file that is dropped to execute certain functions of the malware to execute a Visual Basic script. Now, the most important thing what you should do to prevent the ransomware. Please note this point that once a computer is encrypted this ransomware, it is very difficult to decrypt the files because the private keys that are required to decrypt the ransomware are not available as of now. And the most important thing all users and administrators have to take is determine the version of your Windows systems and apply the patches as mentioned in the Microsoft Security Bulletin MS-17010. This bulletin has been released on March 15th, and information regarding this bulletin and vulnerability notes have been issued by CERTIN in March 2017 itself. So this bulletin needs to be seen by the users, and the patches which are mentioned in this bulletin for appropriate Windows versions need to be applied. And it may also be noted that many of the users are using unsupported versions, Windows XP, Server 2003, etc. These are not supported by Microsoft anymore, so regular patches are not available. So users are encouraged to upgrade their systems to prevent such threats. Currently, for this particular malware is affecting all these older unsupported versions also. And you may be using these systems at homes and organizations. So you are required to update appropriate patches for your version that you are using by going to this particular link. Both these URLs have been published on our advisory that is published on www.cert-in.org.in as well as the Cyber Swachhata Kendra website. Nevertheless, another important thing to prevent or counter ransomware threat particularly is because it is targeting your critical data, and you may be doing very vital data on your systems as an individuals, as an organizations. It is always advised to take backup of your systems and keep it offline. And organizations using critical services need to take backup of the critical data regularly so that even if some computer is crashed down or infected by this ransomware, you can restore the critical data from your trusted backups. Please note this point also that if you have applied these particular patches to your Windows systems, you are protected from this particular malware from propagating. But if as an organization or a user, if this particular thing is not available, that is you are unable to apply the patch, you are advised to isolate the system from network first, download the patches to a CD and or pen drive, and apply it to the standalone system first the patch, and then only you connect to the network. Otherwise, there is a highly chance that the system will be infected. And you should also note this point that this malware spreads very quickly through the LAN because it is exploiting vulnerability in SMB. Further, the enterprises should also block UDP port 137, 138, 139, and TCP port 139 and TCP port 445 at the perimeter. This is generally done as a best practice by the enterprises. If you have not done that, you are advised to do that immediately. And at the user level, users should disable protocol SMB v1. The guidance has been given on our website. So you go to our website and see the guidance how to disable that. There is a specific article of Microsoft which advises to disable SMB version 1 protocol on Windows systems. So in general, to prevent these threats, because it is very difficult to recover the data once you are infected with such threats, most important thing is you deploy appropriate antivirus protection, maintain updated antivirus on your system, and you also have to block the spam at your mailbox, use appropriate mail filters. Even if you receive some mails from unsolicited emails, even if you know those people who are sending the contact list, you are in the trusted contact list, never click on those attachments for those emails and never click on any URL contained in such unsolicited email. because that will contain, that may contain a malware embedded in the attachment. And always perform regular backups of all critical information to limit the impact of the data or system loss and to help expedite the recovery process. So as a user, you should always do the important thing you should keep in mind is backup your data and keep it offline, which is not connected to the internet. Another most important thing is the malware files come through attachments which are embedded as a macros. So disable macros in Microsoft Office products. Guidelines are given on our website. For enterprises, very important things to note is implement the best practice at your mail server level, the sender policy framework, domain message authentication reporting and confirmation DMARC standard, and domain keys identified mail DKIM for your domain, which is the email validation system and designed to prevent spam by detecting email spoofing. This email spoofing technique is used by most of the ransomware samples which to successfully reach the corporate email boxes. So you should be able to detect the spoofed mails which are coming from outside to your corporate or enterprise and then disable and drop it at the gateway itself. Another important best practices to the enterprises and organizations are use appropriate application whitelisting solutions on the critical systems where only trusted applications and important applications need to run and other untrusted applications and additional applications need not run. And you can also implement software restriction policies to block binaries running from app data, program data, and temp paths, so that which will prevent execution of malware even after infection. And enforce application whitelisting in all endpoint workstations also through appropriate solutions so that the infections will not affect the endpoint workstations. And deploy web and email filters on your network and configure these your perimeter devices to scan for known bad domains, sources, IP addresses. Block these before the receiving and downloading the messages. And your all incoming emails and attachments and downloads on both host at the mail gateway should be scanned with a reputed antivirus solution, and this antivirus solution should be updated regularly. For this particular threat, the WannaCry ransomware threat, detailed countermeasures, best practices, prevention tools, indicators of compromise, that is malicious IP addresses, domains, hash values of the files, etc., are and signatures rules that are to be deployed at intrusion detection systems and intrusion prevention systems and YARA rules are mentioned on our website. This website can be accessed on www.cybersvachitakendra.gov.in and this particular alert is visible here. You may also note that we have security tools that are freely available on this particular website. You can go to security tools section and use those tools to prevent infections and secure your systems. And currently we have received around 7 variants of this particular ransomware, and detection has been aided on the free botnet removal tool which is hosted on this particular website. So users are encouraged to visit our website and use this tool to remove infections. In general also, this particular tool detects many of the prevalent botnet families and removes. So users are encouraged to visit this website, use the free tool section, security tool section, and download the tool and use the tool to remove the bots and malware from your systems. So what should you do if you are, by the way, infected by the WannaCrypt ransomware and the screen is shown as infected? Immediately isolate the system from network because it will prevent propagation of this malware to the other network computers within the LAN, and run cleanup tools mentioned on our website to disinfect the same. Before running these tools, prevent data even if it is encrypted, because sometimes researchers find the decryption methodologies, it will take some time to work on that. So don't throw away the data. Even if it is encrypted, store the data somewhere so that when decryption tools are available, you can recover the data. And do not pay the ransom. That will encourage the criminals to do such more attacks. Report incident to CERTIN and the local law enforcement agencies so that we can work on that. For any further questions, you can send email to incident@cert-in.org.in. And you can also call, on our toll-free number 1800114949, and you can also send fax to 1800116969. And users and organizations are encouraged to regularly visit the website www.cert-in.org.in website for latest security threats and alerts and updated alerts on this particular ransomware as well, and www.cybersvachitakendra.gov.in website to download free malware botnet removal tools and clean your systems. Thank you. I hope that has given enough information about this particular threats. And more updates will be available on our advisories on our website. So please keep visiting these websites and take actions as suggested. And report incidents on phone or email ID as mentioned here. Thank you.